Professor Manjul Bhargava will deliver the convocation address. Professor Ashutosh Sharma, who was to be here as the chief guest, is unable to come due to some other engagements. I guess most, if not everyone in the audience, know that Manjul Bhargava is recipient of the prestigious Fields Medal in 2014. Manjul Bhargava did his undergraduate education at Harvard University and went on to work with Andrew Wiles at Princeton University for his PhD. He was appointed full professor at Princeton University in 2003, just 2 years after his PhD. He has received numerous awards and prizes, including the Clay Research Award in 2005, the Sastra Ramanujan Prize in 2005, the Frank Nelson Cole Prize of the American Mathematical Society in 2008, and the Infosys Prize in 2012. Born in Canada and raised in USA, Manjul Bhargava has remained close to his Indian roots. His grandfather, Purushottam Lal Bhargava, a prominent linguist and scholar of ancient Indian history, trained Manjul in Sanskrit. His first mathematics teacher was his mother, Professor Meera Bhargava, who is with us here. As you might have read in newspapers yesterday, Manjul has keen interest in music and is an accomplished tabla player and has been a student of Ustad Zakir Hussain. I'm very happy to recall here that one of our students, Arul Shankar, went on to work with Manjul for his PhD, and their joint work was quoted in his Fields Medal citation. I hope Manjul will visit CMI often enough and spend time here inspiring young minds in years to come. I will now briefly report on activities of the CMI during the last year. Large proportion of graduates from CMI in the past decade have gone on to pursue further studies at best academic institutions in India and abroad, and good proportion of them have completed their PhD. The institutions where our students have gone include Berkeley, Caltech, Chicago, Harvard, MIT, NYU, Kurang Institute, Princeton, Penn State, Yale in USA, ENS Paris, ENS Cachan, University Paris, University Bordeaux, France, Max Planck Institutes, and Humboldt University in Germany, and Harishchandra Research Institute, IITs, IMSC, ISIR, and TIFR in India. Over a dozen CMI graduates have returned to India after completing their PhDs to take up academic positions at institutions like CMI, IMSC, IIT Bombay, IIT Kanpur, TIFR, ISIR Mohali, ISIR Pune, as well as in research labs such as Microsoft Research, ABB Research, IBM India Research Lab. Another dozen have faculty or postdoctoral research positions at academic and research institutes across the world. Students with CMI PhDs have taken up academic positions at IIT Bombay, IIT Guwahati, and IIM Indore. CMI graduates have also moved into areas such as financial mathematics, management and economics, both in India and abroad. The places where they have found placements include IBM, TCS, R&D, Veritas, Barclays, Goldman Sachs, HSBC, ICICI, New Sigma, and some startups. CMI has exchange programs with leading French institutions such as École Normale Supérieure in Paris, Cachan, as well as École Polytechnique. CMI is one of the three non-European partners in the Erasmus Mundus Master Project program ELGANT, Algebra, Geometry and Number Theory, funded by the European Union. The ELGANT program allows students to pursue master and doctoral degrees across the institutions participating in the program. In computer science, CMI along with IMSC and IISc is part of an international associated laboratory set up by the French National Center for Scientific Research, CNRS. Here are some of the major activities at CMI during the year. CMI just completed 25 years. And to celebrate the same, we have had a year-long program of Silver Jubilee Lectures, where several distinguished scholars have come and given lectures. Professor David Mumford, Brown University, USA, gave the inaugural lectures in this series in September last year. Other speakers in this series include P.S. Thyagarajan from National University of Singapore, R. Balasubramaniam, IMSC, Mukund Dattai, NCBS Bangalore, Jaykumar Radhakrishnan, TIFR, Albert Vollmer from University of Hanover, Germany, Kim Plofker, Union College, New York, Parosh Aziz Abdullah, Uppsala University, Sweden, Madhusudan, MIT and Microsoft Research, Deepak Day, University of Connecticut, Srinivas Varadhan, New York University, Peter Simmons, University of Manchester, Ahmed Bhojani, University of Paris 7, V. Lakshmibai, Northeastern University, Alladi Sitaram, ISI Bangalore, Howard Schaumburg, Boston College, Deepak Dhar, TIFR Mumbai, Pascal Weil, Lavery, University of Bordeaux, Paris, Philip Schnobel, ENS Kasha, Bala Iyer, ICTS, TIFR Bangalore, Tarun Shauradeep, Ayuka Pune, Shukant Bose, Ayuka Pune, Kavita Ramanan, Brown University, Naresh Dadich, Ayuka Pune, Raghuram from ISR Pune, Manjunath Krishnapur, ISA Bangalore, Michael Barry, University of Bristol, Sandeep Trivedi, TIFR. So we have had a busy year. The conference and workshops which were organized by CMI during the previous year include recent developments in commutative algebra and applications to classical rings here, NCM Advanced Instructional School in Algebraic Number Theory, the first CMI alumni conference, fourth workshop on automata, concurrency and time systems, astronomy, cosmology and fundamental physics with gravitational waves, research workshop and conference on statistical methods in finance, Indo-Russian conference on probability theory and statistics which was held at ISI Delhi, lecture program for students of class 11 and 12 in association with National Academy of Sciences, Allahabad. Under our arts initiative, we have started a writers in residency program in collaboration with Sangam House, and we host two writers for about 6 weeks or so at who are residents at CMI during January-March. So in 2005, we hosted Mathilde Walter Clark and N.S. Konings, who spent the 6 weeks here. Kim Flofker, Union College, New York, and Clemency Montel, University of Canterbury, coordinated our annual History of Mathematics session in November, December. During this, there was a workshop titled Found in Translation, Rediscovering Classical Indian Mathematics, where several leading people in these areas participated. CMI hosts a number of distinguished academic visitors every year, and during the past year, as usual, there were many seminars delivered by visiting scholars. Over the years, CMI is getting its major funding from Department of Atomic Energy via the National Board of Higher Mathematics. UGC joined hands and has been giving us funds for activities such as construction of the building, which is progress in stages. Part of it is occupied and is used, and in addition, we are building three more stories. Recently, DST has come forward to support CMI, and DAE and DST have signed an agreement to support CMI. The DST support to CMI comes via SERB, Science and Engineering Research Board, while the support from DAE will continue to come via NBHM. In addition to this generous support from DAE, DST and UGC, CMI also receives support from private sources. We have established a faculty development fund for supporting research activities at the institute, and we have received generous donations from well-wishers. Of course, last year Infosys gave us a fair amount of money for corpus, which is also supporting various research activities. Dr. Swaminathan had made a generous endowment in memory of his uncle K. Lakshmanan, and Dr. Usha Rubugante made a similar endowment in memory of her husband. This has led to annual Lakshmanan and Rubugante memorial lectures at CMI. This year, Krishna Atreya, Distinguished Professor Emeritus, College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, Iowa State, USA, delivered the Lakshmanan Memorial Distinguished Lecture on What is the Markov Chain. Dipendra Prasad from TIFR Mumbai delivered the R.K. Rubugante Distinguished Lecture on Modular Forms, Motives and L-Functions. The family of Sri Madhav Sharma, who was the secretary to the CMI Trust, has made a donation for an annual lecture in his memory. This year, David Mumford, Professor Emeritus of Applied Mathematics, Brown University, USA, delivered the K. Madhav Sharma Memorial Distinguished Lecture on Mathematical Models for the Heavens, from Yugas to Chaos. That was the title. Thanks to the support from the government as well as private donors, we have established CMI as a much desired destination for students to study mathematics, computer science and physics, and for faculty to teach and carry out their research. I am confident that CMI will continue to grow as a center of excellence in years to come. I once again welcome you all and declare this convocation open.